Let us move now to Dr. Abla's presentation. I don't know which viewpoint you will give us. Will it be optimistic or not? Let's take it as a surprise of the day. We were moving on a zigzag line. You are optimistic. Mr. Ziad is also optimistic. Dr. Ahmed, very intelligently, pointed out to our problems. Dr. Hussein took us down, and then Tarek tried to boost our morale. So my natural order here in the discussion is to take you down again. This is how I'm naturally seated and ordered here. Plus, it complies with my personality as a researcher. I want to touch upon 4 points that were tackled in the discussion. The methodology, what is our benchmark of comparison? I want to comment on some indicators. And finally, where do we want to stand? Regarding the methodology, there is a piece of information which is not everybody's familiar with, but at the Egyptian Center, we are well aware of it, because we are the ones who receive the questionnaires and fill them out. Last year, we did the same homework, and we send it, but it was not responded to. Why? Because they found that there are differences compared with the last few years. They found an improvement, and they said we would not use it. We want to make sure that there is a trend of improvement. So last year, they put the same results of the previous year, because they take the average of 2 years. If you notice, 115 is the same ranking 2016 and the same one in 2015. This year, they received the 2017 result for 1 year only, not for 2 years. What does this mean? So if we are speaking about an improvement, this improvement did not happen in one year, but in 2 years. I'm again is the exaggeration to have a jump in our figures. This is one point. Secondly, the methodology. The methodology is problematic. To say that methodology is based on the perception of the people, this is not wrong. This is not bad. The perception might be better than the reality or less than the reality. And this applies to many of the indicators. The other countries do have more information than us. Perception gives you a lot about the country. So this indicator and the others, and this was reiterated by big economists in the world, the perception is giving us a guideline, but we should not be happy with it. But at the same time, I don't say self-logging, but I say it self-criticism. We will not have a progress unless we criticize ourselves. Dr. Hussein said a point very skillfully. If we look at our 2030 agenda, we want to be one of the top countries. If we take our these indicators, we will not reach this. We do two comparisons, one between this year and last year, and one between this year and 2010-2011. 2011, our situation was high, whether we were satisfied or not. But it was high. This is regarding the methodology and the comparison. Also, we are keen to compare ourselves with other countries. In comparison with the rest of countries, this is a big question mark. And where do we stand? What is our situation? We are in group two in the efficiency-driven. The weights of indicators and their improvement really show that we have not moved a lot. Reiterating what Hussam and Ziad said. Looking at the sub-indicators or subsidiary indicators is something important that we need to pay attention to. First of all, the transparency of decision-making and the instability of policies. These are key issues, not because they are easy to do and they are not costed in the budget, but they are the cornerstone. All our weaknesses are all associated with the real economy and with institutional reform, and they have been continuous with us since long time ago. we are improving, but it looks like as if we are moving on a treadmill. Things that remain constant, they need to change in order to reach what we are opting for. Education. Education is non-debatable. Every country that achieved the progress paid due attention to education. We have the ambassador of Singapore. I'd like to welcome him. Education is in the budget, it is 20% of the GDP in Singapore. We are so far from Singapore. In vocational training, we need to achieve leaps and breakthroughs and in order to achieve quick results. Egypt will cooperate with Singapore in this issue, but we need to do it. The interest, paying attention to human development is very important. There are many things that we are still very far. So, indicators, although they are still perceptions, and despite some improvements that took place in the last few months, but the message is very clear. We are still so far from what we are expecting. Where should we stand? We need to endeavor to achieve sustainable development. Sustainable development does not mean to have a zigzag line, but to have continuity. It's a requirement. It's imperative. We need to move on the high road, not the low road. The low road achieves some development, and we carry problems and challenges with us. Okay, it's based on subsidy, non-skilled labor, industries that are based on natural resources. We are at the tail end of the value chain of all products. Yes, they are progressing, but we don't achieve this kind of development. So we are on the low road. But if I wanted to improve the livelihood of people, the living conditions, the human development, to take Egypt to the position that it really deserves, we need to be on the high road. High road means that we carry out real reforms. We started economic reforms. This is true. We took courageous steps. Yes, it's true. But these courageous steps are related to the fiscal side. Structural reform, real institutional reforms only happen, or they happen, but very slowly. And there are drivers, change drivers, that still we do not do, like database. If we don't have information or database, I will not take sound decisions. We created databases long time ago, but they never were finalized. The real estate wealth, we had a session about this the center. It could bring 60, 70 billion Egyptian pounds per annum if these databases were finalized. So, corruption, the corruption which we are suffering from, corruption is associated with an institutional failure and bureaucracy. In bureaucracy, there is a waste of resources and lots of problems. Our main issue of reform is that big part of reform, we ask it to happen through the same institutions, the same faces, and the same people who are still in their comfort zone. They are making benefit and gains from this, and I'm asking those people to create the change, and this will not happen. That's why we need a higher commission for education. We need lots of things to be put in place. And so I want to reiterate this wake-up call that Dr. Hossein pointed out, to have a wake-up call. I think this is very good. Yes, we have an opportunity ahead. We should not fall in the same traps like other countries. It's a must. The technological advancement in informatics, in telecommunications, provided us with quick fixes, solutions, potentials, but we need to adopt sturdily real and institutional reforms in this country in order to achieve what we want, and daringly we take our report and compare ourselves with number one. Thank you.